everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's good to see your faces. We're doing something new this month because we've all had a turn in our professional highlight. We wanted to kind of mix it up a little bit and do something similar, but even hopefully more value add. And so I've talked about it on our network. It's called a business spotlight. And what a spotlight is, if you haven't had a chance to watch the video or read the post, spotlight is your opportunity to fill out a quick little survey. Just really talk about what it is that your pain points are at the moment in your business, or some struggles, or some bigger objective that you want to achieve. And then we come together as a group of networkers to support one another. And this sort of time that we have, which is only an hour, is for the person who is choosing to be in the spotlight, which today is Samantha Paul, to talk about what it is that, you know, she or that person is encountering. Talk through that a little bit. We are supposed to listen and take good notes. And then we have an opportunity to speak back and talk to her about what we hear. And that's very short and concise. You know, what I hear the problem is, or sounds like you've got this going on, or it sounds like you're needing to or wanting to achieve this, that kind of practice. Then we're going to take a little bit of time, about 10, 15 minutes, to brainstorm some solution. That puts us at three-quarter of the hour. And then Samantha will get the opportunity or the person in the spotlight today, Samantha, will get the opportunity to grab and go. And what grab and go is just grab a couple of suggestions, grab a couple of ideas that resonate with her, and then take 1 to 3 small tangible things that can be grabbed, that are measurable and can be transferred into action. So the whole idea is to come full circle at the top of the hour with the person in the spotlight, having been supported in getting some new, fresh ideas and how they can overcome their challenge or reach their objective, their goals. And for that person, then we are here to support them as they come back with holding themselves accountable, with following through on those grab and go items, small actionable steps that they can take. Does that all make sense? Samantha, why don't you take a few moments, 10 to 15 minutes, this is the first part of that hour, to talk us through what it is that you're encountering at the moment and what the objective is of this time here together. And if you get stuck, I have my notes from your survey and I'll be able to guide you along.
Awesome. Thank you. Well, good morning, everyone. You guys are one of the first groups to know that I was leaving my real job, I call it, and going out on my own. And so fitting that you'll be the group that I'm going to share kind of this little bit of a hurdle that I'm having as I do this. So just a month gone from Sonoma County Tourism, and now planning on my own. I've always had planning clients that I've been planning for, and so it's not anything new for me per se. It's just new to be fully immersed in being self-employed. And as a self-employed household, because my husband is also self-employed, that has always been the scary thing for us. And so, you know, that is probably my biggest hurdle, but I don't think any of you can fix that for me. So what I'm actually, you know, really challenged by as I go out on my own and in this journey is I do a lot of things. And I think all of you, you know, those of you who know me and certainly through the network, you've seen that. And I shared with Bianca that people keep taglining me along those lines of like, she does everything, big or small, Samantha Paul does it all. That is not my tagline. Not my brand, but that's, you know, that's kind of where I fall. I do a lot of different things. I love to do a lot of different things. And so, you know, as I narrow in what my focus will be and how I'm going to market my business and what I do and how I can serve my clients and community, it is really looking at that. I'm an event planner, but I'm much more than just, you know, the pretty things that happen at events. I'm strategizing with my clients on their goals, on their mission and vision, how they, you know, achieve their goals through their event, how they achieve engagement. And I'm also risk and crisis planning with them. that's the reality of where we are today, not just with COVID, not just with fire season, but really it's a reality of where we are with events. And, you know, anything can happen at any time. And so I work my clients through that process. I have a plan A, B, C, and D for all of my events through the end of the year, but that's not new for me. So it's really kind of, you know, I'm an event planner. I'm an event strategist. I'm an event producer. But what's that, you know, what's that? How do I convey that to my clients or my potential clients, to my community? And then I'm also, you know, being in the industry for as long as I have been and having the experience that I have, I also work with venues and other collaborators in the industry to kind of coach them through, you know, what they do and how to, you know, market themselves, how to sell themselves, and how to, you know, kind of elevate their services as well. And so that's another caveat of something that I wrap into what I do as a consultant. And then I'm also a writer. And so, you know, writing content for individuals, writing content for businesses, writing content for magazines, which has been a kind of new thing, but that developed out of writing a lot of content. And especially when I was at SCT, that became a big piece of what I did. So, you know, all of those things, and how do I wrap those together as what I put forth for people to know what I do? I recently had a new client engaging with me, and I had to like kind of take a pause and say, shoot, how do I tell you exactly what I do? I know what you need from me. It's one thing of the many that I do, but how do I, you know, how do I present that? Because if you go to my website, that's not going to be what you see. You know, I haven't focused in on your specific need on my website in just that. And it's not ideal for me to have a website for everything that I do. And so really kind of talking through, you know, what are some of those things, like you're all, you know, you all have experience out in the business world. You've worked with somebody like me at some point. And so kind of when you hear me say these things, like, you know, what stands out to you is I might be trying to tackle something that, or wrangle something that you already can recognize, or that maybe I don't need to wrangle. So that's kind of what I wanted to bring to the group today.
So first, obviously you and I are sisters at some point in time, because I have the same problem. Event planners do everything. They really do, no matter what. And the more experience you have, the broader that spectrum comes. And yet most business wisdom tells us to narrow. And I find it personally really hard to do exactly what you're trying to do as well. You are so talented and you are so kind and gracious that everybody is attracted to you, but that doesn't make it easy to monetize it. I would look at the things that would allow you to make money and serve as a priority. Yeah, I know that we all talk about the importance of serving others, but I think that sometimes we do that and forget that we also have bills to pay.
My husband's gonna not let me forget that one.
Gotta put food on the table.
So one of the things, Samantha, that I'm just noticing is, you know, I love a good circle, right? But when you were talking about the things you do, all the things you do, the event planner, strategic strategist, strategic advisor, producer, and then coach, trainer, coach, advisor, consultant, and then writer. And then you jumped to your website conversation and meeting your clients' needs before they meet you, because that's really what a website is, right? They go to check you out and they meet you there before they meet you in person, or they check you out there before because somebody told them to. I've never done this, but it would be so interesting to see a site that promotes a person's skills and the outcome they want for their client, rather than promoting their services, mm-hmm. Right? So think like the things that you bring to the table in terms of your skills and the outcome that you set a pretty high bar for people to expect of you, right? Like you set this bar and they expect that. And that's why people say that thing, big or small, Samantha can do it all. you know, and like she can do it all because you set that bar. So if you had a site, I wonder if you had even just a communication piece that said outcome-based, this is what it is you can expect of me. I wonder what would be on there. It's one of the things that I heard you talk about, like the outcome that they can expect of you.
Thank you, Ian. That's super interesting. I put together a somewhat of a portfolio, really just a new potential client, an idea of what I do or who I've done work for. And they asked me for my resume. And I was like, well, my resume is not going to tell you that I do that one thing for you. And so I did do a skills and abilities outline for them, but it's not on my website. So that is interesting. Thank you, Bianca.
I was just going to say, I think that ties into just everyone's branding. And what do you do? What is your response to that question? Well, that's why Tom and I work together, because we do, it's the same sphere, but we talk about two different things in the same sphere. And I think we all have areas of our practices and our businesses and our organizations where we do different things. How do you explain it cleanly to encompass all the things we do so well? It's really challenging to do that, which is why it's really easy to focus on that one item when somebody asks you that. And I think that is the issue I face a lot of the times. Like, what do you do? I'm like, what do you need? You know, like, I don't know what I can help you with, but that's the nature of my business, because it's so individualistic when somebody in front of me is asking that question. So that said, when you're opening up a new business or just getting started, you know, it's kind of like I feel like you have to pick which one you're going to say. And if they don't click, that's fine, because there's somebody else that would click with. It's just a numbers game, right? Of who you're talking to that would make sense for. And then obviously refining what makes the most sense from a marketability standpoint and so on. But yeah, I think we all face that issue, especially as a new business owner. That is by far one of the biggest challenges I've faced. So
it's like you need to know like what it is that you do, so you can easily just like say it and you know, move through it. I was also looking at your website too. I feel like I love like your events pages when you like dive into what you do for each one. The homepage just feels like you just do events. And so like, you know, adding more to that, I think, and I love like Bianca's like, what is your end solution? Because you don't always, like you're always so thoughtful, because I get to work with you side by side with your clients, and you're very like, it is what is the end result, you know, like what it is that you're going to help your clients with and achieve. And I think hitting home with that would be great.
One of the things that I'm hearing too, and this might be applicable for all of us, think about the clients that we work with and, you know, each one of us respectively. The client will know you most likely for something specific, right? And if you are a great problem solver, for example, they might know you for how you dealt with a problem that was very overwhelming for them, but because you're an expert, you solved that problem and they remember how you made them feel. But we don't just get business, and most of the time, we don't just get business from our clients. We actually get business from our network, from other people who don't necessarily experience us in our expertise. So they will know you for your overall approach, how you appear, your appearance, right? And so one of the questions that I jotted down as I was listening to you is, what do you want to be known for? And this is a question that we all need to answer for ourselves. What do I want to be known for?